With the election less than 40 days away, where do each of the candidates stand when it comes to foreign policy and national security?
In a new book called The Choice, our next guest breaks down those differences and lays out what's at stake in November.
That author and Fox News national security and foreign affairs analyst and former Trump campaign foreign policy advisor Waleed Faris joins us now with more. Waleed, thanks for being here. Let's take a look at one of President Trump's accomplishments during his first term, and that is ending the deal with Iran put in place by the Obama administration. You know, one of the things when it comes to the presidency, Waleed, is often it's defined by foreign policy. Often it's defined by what you do not expect to happen across the world. How do you expect these two guys to approach this differently?
Well, absolutely. I mean, in the book, I look at 15 areas of foreign policy. 8 of them are about national security. 3 of them are extremely important. That would include ISIS, the Iran deal, and of course the peace accord. And I think that there is a major difference night and day between the 8 years of Obama-Biden administration's foreign policy and the 4 years of the Trump-Pence administration's foreign policy. And I begin with the first and most important one, basically, is the Iran deal. The Iran deal had given Iran regime so much power, so much money to buy more weapons, and to control 4 countries in the Middle East. The withdrawal by the Trump administration of the Iran deal was the major change that benefited the Middle East. And of course, we saw now the fruits of that withdrawal in terms of peace and in terms of security in the region.
Yeah, and opened up a lot of other opportunities, which we'll talk about as well. But President Obama called them the JV team. President Trump crushed them. What was the main difference in the approaches in the defeat of ISIS?
It's time. It's a, you know, for, ISIS ruled 2/3 of Iraq, parts of Syria from 2014 till the end of 2016. And the Obama administration, because they were careful with the Muslim Brotherhood and other considerations, did not put all the efforts to eliminate ISIS in a geographical sense, while the Trump administration was able to do it very quickly. And what is important, we maintain the force on the ground not to let ISIS to come back, neither to Iraq or to Syria in the ISIS-controlled areas.
Waleed, can you speak a little bit about the Abraham Accords and the role of peace agreements, comparing the Trump administration and the Obama administration on that issue?
Well, we heard former Secretary Kerry just a few weeks ago saying that it is impossible and unacceptable that any peace accord will be done between Israel and any Arab country before the resolution of all the problems between Israel and the Palestinians. Well, what we saw a few weeks ago, that 2 major peace accords between the UAE, Bahrain, and Israel, sponsored by this administration, were possible in a span of 40 days. So it is possible to engage in peace processes, and that was the major achievement in that regard.
As I pointed out, as you pointed out, so often presidencies defined by foreign policy. Waleed, thanks for pointing out 3 ways these 2 potential administrations diverge. Thank you so much for your
time.
Thank
you, Waleed.
Thank you.